Hello. Some of you have shown an interest in the titanium knives, so I'm going to utilize this utility knife and do a quick melon carving for you. These knives are pretty cool. The nicest thing about them is the ergonomic feel and the fit in your hand. Really nice. Doesn't weigh much. I mean, it's a couple ounces. Really lightweight, and the titanium is very cool. It's got just a neat reflection, neat color to it, and super easy to clean. You basically just wipe it off. So this one's brand new. We're gonna test it out. And I've got a cantaloupe here. Cantaloupe, very simple. We're gonna just a very quick little fruit cup, or you can call it a vegetarian dessert or appetizer, whatever you want to do. I'm going to eat it, but first I'm going to carve it for you. So this is kind of a strange cantaloupe. You want to select a really nice round one and then decide what kind of pattern you're going to do. I like to start and just do kind of a up and down, like a crown style. So we're going to do that today. It's just going to be a crown all the way around. Then we're going to modify it a little bit. I'll show you my plan here shortly. And this particular melon is very, very ripe. It was grown in the USA. I prefer to get the freshest fruits and vegetables that I can find. And quite often they're local. So you got to source out whatever you can get in your area. Get the best stuff you can, I'm telling you. It's not worth it buying the garbage, okay? These cantaloupes are very good for you, high in nutrition, not expensive, just a great fruit. And trying to go very carefully, and also this melon is very ripe, so I have two things I'm kind of fighting here: the ripeness and accuracy. Okay, there you go. Wow, smells incredible. Looks pretty nice too. Okay, I've removed the seeds from the melon. Very nice, very simple. By the way, I have washed the outside. Gotta be careful, keep the germs down. Plus, sometimes I'll stack these babies. That looks pretty cool right there. What a great presentation. All right, I'm gonna start with this piece right here, and I'm gonna use my utility knife and just carefully come down and open these up a little bit like this. Just a quick cut. Okay, this is kind of taking it to another level, because you go to so many restaurants and they don't do this stuff. I mean, this is just nice. Your guests, your customers are going to recognize the fact that you've gone an extra mile for them there. I'm going to put a grape. I've got some grapes here that I've washed and cut in half. And I'm going to put a grape around each one like this. Actually, we're going to alternate red, green like that. All this is doing is lifting the skin back, making it a little bit fancier. And like I said, it's kind of cool. It's kind of a nice funky design we're doing here. Something a little different. I know you haven't seen this before. Because I just came up with it. So there you go. Already looks like a flower. Nice. Okay, now we're gonna fill this with a few other things. I'm going to take this peach. Got this nice ripe peach, very ripe. Cut the peach. Peaches have been hit or miss this year. Yeah, this one is not so good. It's gonna be okay, but I mean, it's not very juicy. And we're gonna do something different with this peach. Maybe you haven't seen this before. We're going to take and remove the inside. Can be sometimes a little bit crunchy, little pit remains. And after we remove the inside like this, we're gonna take a melon baller and we're gonna scoop out the peach, get some little round circles, and I'm gonna be adding these I'm going to be adding these circles to my grape mixture over here. And this is what we're going to put into our cantaloupe cup today. It's something a little different. Anyone eating this is going to go, wow, what are those little circles you got there? You'll have to explain to them that that's a Georgia peach. Just decided to do something a little different. Switch it up a little. Come up with some new ideas. Okay. The rest of this peach will get eaten, of course. I'm just going to put a few more in here. Okay. And I'm almost done with this presentation. This is pretty quick and easy. All right. Got my peaches right there. Nice. I'm going to put some banana in here. Got a half of a perfectly ripe banana right here. Okay. And for the banana, I'm going to, well, everything's round so far. I guess I'm going to continue. I've got an oval baller here. We're going to do some oval bananas. Wow. How cool is that? You never stop learning in culinary arts. I've had students that didn't learn squat, and I've had students that learned an amazing amount of, skills and information. There you go. These are banana quenelles. First time you've seen that. They're going right in there. And we're going to flip it over and repeat. A couple more quenelles. The last thing I'm going to do for this presentation here is introduce you to something you may or may not be familiar with. And that is pure vanilla extract. Oh my God, it's so good. This is a new bottle. Just opening it up here. Shake it up. A few drops like this. That's all you need. And then we're going to mix this up. We're going to mix it up with our rubber spatula like this. Okay. Oh, it smells so good. All the fruits are kind of nice. I've got rounds and ovals. And we're going to take a plate like this, and we're going to add our fresh fruits. Okay. Fruits go in right in the center like this, just enough to fill the melon. Okay. And then we use, of course, our fingers like any skilled chef does. Fingers go in here and you finish the presentation, because you have to make it look really nice. Just like that. 1, 2, 3. I want 3 of my banana quenelles on the top. And that's it. Your sponsor, chefdepot.com. These knives are really cool. You rinse them off, wipe them, nothing sticks to them. I like it. On a scale of 1 to 10, I give this knife probably a 9.5. Very nice. Thanks for watching. Support your sponsor, chefdepot.com. Have a great day. Please support your sponsor, chefdepot.com. Have a great day, and keep cooking.